This is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you, and yes, quite an unlikely place for me to be making an episode for you guys. But literally where we're at is a park here, out in the middle of nature, and I got a little wood chip path that I'm walking upon. And I just wanted to, you know, make a video while I'm here to share with you guys, you know, how the forest system or how nature would work as to building the soil. And what's allowing, whoa man, check it out, that's crazy. They're like some wild turkeys right there. That's insane, oh my gosh. I mean, but this is nature at its finest, right? Some wild turkeys chuckling at me for making a video for you guys. Anyways, I want to let you guys know that there's no pixie spreading 10-10-10 Miracle-Gro or whatever fertilizer here in the forest to allow these trees. I mean, look at these trees. I mean, these trees are like 60 feet, 70 feet or taller, you know. They have small little trees underneath here and large trees and little, like, you know, shrubs and little plants growing out of the ground here. And how did all these things grow if humans are not able to put the 10-10-10 fertilizer that we're supposed to use in our gardens, right? Well, let's check it out. Well, I mean, as we could see here, on the ground, what there is, there's a lot of leaves, right? So what happens is the trees, you know, there's roots in the ground, the trees pull out the nutrients out of the soil, up through its trunks, and then it actually creates the leaves. So all the nutrients that were in the soil are now in the leaves. Then the leaves drop on the ground, right below, and over time these leaves break down. So if we go down over here, you know, we could kind of see some of these leaves broken down, and down below the leaves, there's probably like some nice rich black soil down here. And that's how, you know, a forest system would make the nutrition for the forest. In addition, trees are getting dropped, whether they're, you know, fallen by nature because the tree's old, like in this case here, it looks like it was literally just uprooted and it dropped. And over time, the tree rots out. And once again, nutrients from the ground are in the tree, and a high source of carbon, and going to once again degrade in the soil. You know, I'm not seeing mounds of horse manure, mounds of cow manure, mounds of chicken manure, or even mounds of turkey manure, although we just saw some turkeys here, you know, that things are growing out of. You know, when animals are in the wild, right, they're just pooping wherever they happen to be, man. They're right here. Like, if I gotta go to take a leak, I'm just leaking on the tree right here, man. I'm not gonna leak in one specific area. They just take a dump wherever they gotta go, man. And so, yeah, there's definitely some manure spread across this whole space here that I'm in. But for the most part, you know, this is a closed system where nutrients are being cycled and recycled. So it goes from the soil up to the tree and then back down to the ground and then actually compost down and then goes back in the soil, right? So the challenge arises when man gets involved and we've stripped mined the land of all the trees, of all the plants, and then we put down a house and the topsoil has been bulldozed away to make a nice pad for the house, and I don't know where that ends up. Or with conventional farming, they've just been mining nutrients out of the earth and not putting the full complex synergistic, you know, trace minerals and replacing what was back in the earth, you know, to have a lush, beautiful forest system like we're looking at here. My goal as a gardener is to literally try to duplicate what's here. Now, yeah, I'm not gonna be growing a forest in my house to let all the leaves drop and compost that and all this stuff. But what I am doing is, you know, I'm using the compost that's already made from vegetative wood chips and yard waste clippings and food scraps and putting that back in my garden. So that's number one, adding organic matter back into the garden. Very important. Now, besides just the bacterial-based compost that I like to add, I also like to add the composted wood chips or the fungal source compost. Be sure to check my past episodes on that. I have a really good one if you guys haven't seen it. It's actually called Supersizing Your Plant Growth with Wood Chips and Rock Dust. And actually, that's another thing I like to add is the trace minerals, the rock dust. So, you know, we've been mining things out of the soil, and I want to put things back in. I mean, if you have virgin land that was a forest once, you may not need to do this, but I would still recommend it. But adding the trace minerals back in the soil, because you're going to get even more productive plant growth than what was there, because now you can add things, you know, and get it in there so that your plants could fully thrive. another component besides the organics, the trace minerals, the third component of my growing system that's very critical is the microbes. This is all undisturbed soil. I mean, there's tons of trees in here, man. And down below, what we can't see in the soil, there's like billions and trillions of different microbes and a whole food soil web of different life force and creatures in the soil, from arthropods and bacteria and fungi and earthworms, all different kind of creatures doing their thing, you know, including the insects, you know, basically breaking down the organic matter and making it available for the trees and for the plants that are growing here. So that's the third component, you know, is to add the life back into your soil, whether you're adding the, you know, beneficial microbes, beneficial fungi, or things like earthworms that are relatively easy to add. In addition, I also like to add, because I don't have a huge earthworm population in some of my gardens, I like to add the earthworm castings. And be sure to check my past videos on the earthworm castings, because not all worm castings are created equal, for sure. You know, some worm castings can improve your yields by up to 400%, as shown in studies, but some other ones may not give that dramatic results. So yeah, that's a little quick episode I wanted to share with you guys today. You know, how does a forest work? Think how a forest works. And, you know, I want you guys always in your life, no matter what it is, to try to duplicate nature. I mean, we are all creatures of nature, and we try to put things in bags and simplify nature and just put these bag products on our soil, like the, you know, factory made chemical fertilizers, which is trying to shortcut nature, man. And when you shortcut nature, you run into issues. You know, I mean, I think the food system is one way people are trying to shortcut nature in this day and age. Instead of growing food, you know, they got little food in packages that are, you know, shelf stable and gonna last a million years and whatnot. We need to eat foods out of nature, live in nature, and duplicate and follow some of the rules found in nature, you know, for the best garden ever. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this quick episode learning about some of my ideas about growing a garden and using nature's methods. Once again, my name is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time. And remember, keep on growing.